Assalamualaikum Dr. Bhatt.
Last week there was an event which took place in Denmark displaying a cartoon, and there is a wide protest going across the globe in against whatever was displayed of Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. How should we Muslim respond to this particular when it is catching like a fire across the globe?
There was an event which took place earlier a few months back in Denmark, which was repeated in the press a few weeks back against the Prophet. The background of it is that 30th of September, one of the Danish newspapers, it published 12 cartoons, 12 caricatures of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, which was not in the right spirit, was on the negative side. And many of them were made to defame him. One of them showing him wearing a turban in the way of a time bomb, and along with ladies around him, etc. So this was published on the 30th of September. After it was published, about 3 weeks later, on the 20th of October, the ambassadors of Muslim countries in Denmark and the other Muslim religious people, they approached the Prime Minister and told him what is happening is wrong, and there should be an apology and we should take back all these things, which did not give a good positive response. After that, there were people who tried to tell them that this is wrong. Later on 20th of January, these 12 caricatures, 12 cartoons depicting Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the negative manner, showing me as a religion of terrorism, carrying a sword, along with women wearing a time bomb on his head, etc., all these things, was reprinted in a Norway newspaper. In the Denmark, it was meant to local people in that language. Then the whole issue took place and there was a big hue and cry in the Muslim world. As far as the question is concerned, that how should the Muslims respond to this thing, these things have taken place in the past also. Such things, whether it be Salman Rushdie, whether it be Taslim al-Nasreen, whether it be in USA, whether it be abusing the Prophet. And as you may be aware, that according to a Time magazine report, which came on the 16th of April 1979, in a span of 150 years, from 1800 to 1950, more than 60,000 books have written against Islam. That means more than one book a day was written against Islam in a span of 150 years before. After 9/11, it has reached epidemic levels, maybe several books are written every day. And several articles are coming every day throughout the world, whether on the internet, whether it be on the newspaper, whether it be on satellite channels, whether it be in the form of books or pamphlets. And this has reached epidemic levels. So what should be the response of the Muslims when such articles come or such thing comes in the media, whether it be in the television, whether it be the print media, etc., someone abusing the Prophet or defaming the Prophet? What should be the Muslim stance? And we find people giving different opinions. As far as I'm concerned, my opinion is that broadly, if you categorize the way the Muslim should respond to such defamation and such allegations against Islam, especially the Prophet and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, broadly I can categorize it in six different categories. How can you respond? The first way is replying it in the media, trying to clarify the misconception. And media today, number one best media is the television satellite channel. Then can be the print media, newspapers, magazines. Then can be in the form of pamphlets, can be in the form of books, internet. So number one is the print media, which is the most important. Any Muslim in any part of the world, whether this thing takes place in a Muslim country or non-Muslim country, this allegation against the Prophet or defamation of the Prophet takes place any part of the world, the first three, four categories can be adopted by any Muslim, whether living in a Muslim country or non-Muslim country. So the first four strategies, which are more important, can be adopted by anyone, anywhere, irrespective whether the allegation has taken place in this country or outside, whether Muslim or non-Muslim country. So first is the media. Number two can be a peaceful demonstration of protest, whether in a form of a congregation, whether giving a letter to the embassy of that country where this thing has taken place. If it's Denmark, then you can have a peaceful protest against what has happened and telling the Prime Minister of Denmark that take action against that newspaper, whatever it is. It is a peaceful protest. Whether the audience can be few hundred, few thousand, few hundred thousand, that depends. A peaceful protest. This anyone can do, any Muslim can do, any part of the world. The third type of reaction that can take place from the Muslim, which is positive, it can be a legal action. A legal action. For example, if you can legally pull the defaulters to court and sue them, that's a good way of such things not happening. For example, in USA, there's an organization by the name of CARE, C-A-I-R, which is a very good Muslim organization, which picks up these issues. And just to give an example, You may be aware of the Nike company, also called as Nike, N-I-K-E. Very famous company which makes sports goods, t-shirts, shoes, etc. And they had made a shoe having some Islamic inscription on it or mentioning Allah at the rear side. So you look from behind, Allah was inscribed or it was put at the part of the shoe, which is a defamation. So what they did, that they immediately sued them. And to take the suit file, there was an outside commitment between them. That fine, they paid something $17 million, somewhat similar. I think it's $17 million. And they said, we'll give it to the Muslim community. They can utilize the way they want. So they utilize the money to make parks for the Muslims or Muslim education, whatever they did. So this care company or Muslim organization filed a suit. I don't think so it went into the court because they were afraid the suit would be too high. So they had outside settlement. Whatever it is, whether the court asked them to pay a compensation or outside settlement, it was somewhere close to $17 million, which is, mashallah, a very big amount. Very big amount, maybe, you know, more than 80 crores of rupees, imagine, just for that one act. And they removed the shoes. Main act was, the shoes was removed, it wasn't manufactured. So legal action. So if anything happens, you can think you can go to the court of law. But in certain countries, suing doesn't work. In India, if you sued, hardly you'll come to any conclusion. The law is so that the case may run for 10 years, 20 years. So depending upon the country, in USA the laws are very strict, copyright laws are strict, suing laws are strict. So depending upon the situation, so as far as the first and second strategy can be done anywhere in the world, that is by media replying, clarifying the misconception, writing letters, printing books, what is wrong, what is the right picture of the Prophet and Islam. Number two is a peaceful protest. Number three is legal action, whatever way you can, if it's practical in that country. Even if it's not practical, at least make an effort to see if you can get the person to task. The fourth type of strategy is using economic pressure or business pressure, which may not be applicable again throughout the world. But if you know that by boycotting certain goods of that country where this act has taken place, if act takes place in the country, or that country per se, the Prime Minister is condoning it, not condemning it, that means he's part and parcel to it. Fine? So you boycott that. Like, as you know, what happened in the Gulf country, many of the people, when the Gulf War took place, they boycotted all the American goods, and there was a big loss as far as to America was concerned. And this was an economic embargo or an economic boycott, which no one can object. Internally, people do it. But depending, suppose if I say here that boycott certain goods in America where the percentage of Muslim using is small, so it will be a waste of time. If it's causing an impact and damage to the economy, do it. That is the fourth strategy. The fifth can be a political action. Political action means the Muslim countries themselves, they take a stance.